I chose to go to a discussion on the intersection of science, Islam, and nature by Dr. Nasser for one of my global experiences. And this one, I wasn't really sure exactly all that would entail, but since I go to Catholic Church and I'm a science major, it seemed like something that would be out of my comfort zone, yet still pretty interesting to me. So we walked in, and actually some guys there asked us if we were there for Dr. Nasser, because I guess there was some confusion and double booking with the room. So we were wondering, you know, are we in the right place? And then it got a little awkward. But we stayed, and I'm glad that we did, because it was really interesting. Dr. Nasser is a pretty old guy who teaches at the George Washington University, and he's brilliant. You can tell. He was pretty sick, so it was kind of hard to hear him, but what I did hear was very interesting. He's written several books and done a lot of work. And one of the points that he made was a lot of times people that are trying to learn something new end up trying to forget everything that they know. And he said that in order to study, for example, he was talking about in order to study science as a Muslim person, you have to embrace your roots and embrace the history that you already know before learning new things, and you have to kind of fit them together, piece it together into a puzzle, and blend it into one story rather than two separate textbooks full of information that sort of butt heads, and that you can learn so much more. And he talked about how the Arab world was pretty good at that compared to a lot of the Western world, which was interesting to hear, because I think that's very true, especially with the separation of church and state here. We try to separate out so much of our knowledge into different compartments rather than kind of blending it into our life and blending it into one body of thought. And that was really cool to hear. I really wanted to ask a question, because at the end he opened it up to questions from the audience, but he only took about two, and then he had been really sick, so he stopped taking questions and no longer answered them because he wasn't feeling well, and there was a lot of people there, and I'm sure a lot of questions that would have been asked had he kept the session open for that long. But something that I was going to ask was, as a future science teacher, how, if I have Arab or Muslim students in my classroom, how I can sort of appreciate their culture while also teaching them what we know about science over here and our views of it, but while still respecting theirs and doing as he said and kind of merging them into one understanding rather than their school knowledge and their home knowledge. That really have no relation to each other, because I feel like I'd be a much more effective teacher. So that's something I'll definitely keep in mind, but would have liked to get his input on. And it was, the experience was out of my comfort zone, because it's something that, a religion that I don't really understand very well or know a lot about. And it was intimidating because this man was so knowledgeable about everything that he was saying, and he had researched so much and done so much that it really makes you step back and question everything that you know and that you think, and makes you a little bit uncomfortable, but it also pushes you, which was pretty cool. So, yeah, I need to push myself more in thinking, I guess. But all in all, it was an interesting discussion to hear.